Today's graphic design video is based around logo design valuable tricks that I'm going to show you right now. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Today I've got a list of valuable tricks that you're going to find very useful when designing a logo in Adobe Illustrator. But before that, I quickly want to remind you all that I've got my t-shirts on satorigraphics.net. So go ahead and check out the two designs that I've got up there now and grab one for yourself if you want to help out the channel. Now, let's jump right into these logo design valuable tricks that you can learn today. The first valuable logo design trick relates to strokes on your logo. If you have strokes that are left with stroke widths, it can cause issues later when the logo is rescaled by somebody else. As you can see, I have a hefty stroke on my logo here. First, go up to Object and then Expand Appearance. Then go back to Object and Expand, and use the same settings I'm using here. As you can see, the stroke is now outlined as a vector shape. To finish the trick tip for our logo design with strokes, open the Pathfinder window and merge everything together like so. It's advisable to have two versions of your logo, which leads me onto the next point in today's video. Here I have two versions of my logo. They look the same, but we're going to add some minor changes to one of them. The logo on the left is set up so I can still edit the typography and the strokes, if I ever want to at a later date. However, the logo on the right can be edited so the stroke is vectorized as we did previously, but also we can outline the typography as well. We want to outline the typography so when the logo is shared to a different computer, there will be no issues when recognizing the font. So always save your logo design in two versions. One you're able to edit, and the other version print ready. The next logo design trick in Adobe Illustrator is to use the artboard tool. This is a great tool for logo designing as you can hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate your artboard and your design. You can then make changes to the logo and refine it, and then repeat the process over and over as your logo design develops. Also, you can edit the name of each individual artboard whilst using the artboard tool, as well as move the artboard around your screen. The fourth valuable logo design trick is great for saving logo designs for the web. You may have several designs on several artboards, but with the asset tool you can save them all at once as different designs. Simply open up the asset export window and then drag and drop your designs into the window. But first, check out the different options that you have, such as saving for PNG and JPEG, and also presets for iOS and Android. Once you've dropped your designs in, hold down Shift and select multiple logo designs at once, and then click Export when ready. The default location for your logo design files should be Creative Cloud. And as you can see, all the logo designs here are saved as separate designs, which saves a whole lot of time. I love this logo design trick, as I often use it myself. The last valuable logo design trick that I have for you today is to simplify your logo. If you look closely, your logo may have a huge amount of anchor points. Less is always better in this situation, as long as the shape of the logo remains true. So go up to Object, Path, and Simplify. You can then click Preview and adjust the amount of anchor points on your logo design. Remember that you want a happy medium between the amount of points on the logo, as well as keeping the shape true. So, did you find this tutorial on valuable tricks in logo design helpful? Let me know in the comment section below, and also let me know what you want to see on this channel. Remember to like and share my content if you do enjoy it. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.